Now, evolution can be a good thing, at least when it comes to the evolution of an already good ATV. The 2012 Kawasaki Brute Force 750 has received some pretty significant upgrades that include an even more powerful V-twin engine, a revised front suspension, and new six-spoke cast alloy wheels, and new bodywork. Well, climbing on the Brute Force, you're going to find the great set of digital gauges. Now, included in the gauge pod is a speedometer and odometer, dual trip odometers, a clock, an hour meter, the fuel gauge and low fuel warning light, neutral and reverse indicators, the two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive indicator lights, and a low oil warning light. The Brute Force, like all Kawasaki's, is equipped with individual front and rear braking system, which means that on the right handlebar is the front brake lever. Also there is the two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive rocker switch that allows you to switch back and forth between two-wheel drive and four-wheel drive on the fly. On the left handlebar is the hand lever for the rear brakes, the progressive front differential lock lever, and the quick ratchet-style parking brake. Thanks to revised tuning, a new cylinder head, and an increased compression ratio, the 2012 Brute Force 750's 90-degree 749cc V-twin engine offers even more power than before. The twin cylinders are fed by a fuel injection system that includes 36mm throttle bodies that are controlled by a 32-bit CPU. That CPU also monitors coolant temperature, air intake temperature, air intake pressure, throttle position, vehicle speed, and crankshaft angle to deliver the optimum fuel mixture for every situation. There is also a new, larger radiator placed higher in the chassis for better protection against the mud buildup and debris damage. That radiator also has a larger fan and larger diameter cooling hoses and pipes to help maximize the cooling performance. The ultimate power production is also helped by the reverse-facing straight-tubed intake tracks and four valves per cylinder. This power is transferred to the driveline via an upgraded dual-range continuously variable transmission that now has a higher gear ratio and a thicker belt made of stronger material that will contribute to longer CVT belt life and reduced maintenance requirements. They also revised the converter weight and drive spring tuning to offer improved acceleration characteristics and increased control during low-speed operation. There's also a new layout and revised placement of the CVT air duct that is more efficient at helping prevent water and mud from getting into the transmission. The 2012 Brute Force 750 4x4i also features a new, stronger, double-cradle tubular steel frame that features reinforcements at some of the more key areas, like the front A-arm mounts, the rear stabilizer mounts, engine mounts, and even the footrest mounts. There's also an all-new front suspension layout that features the shock absorbers that are mounted with a little bit more angle between the upper and lower arms to help minimize the sag and allow a higher ground clearance to be maintained once the rider is sitting on the ATV. The front arms feature preload adjustable shocks with 6.7 inches of travel, and the rear suspension that employs a leading torsion sway bar have 7.5 inches of travel. The entire steering assembly has been revised as well, now repositioned so that the bottom of the steering shaft no longer connects to the front differential housing. Now, the movement of the differential due to the throttle inputs in 4x4 mode no longer affect the steering assembly. This isolates the steering and provides significantly smoother handling. Even the bodywork has been revised. The changes include a new covered hood storage compartment in the center of the front rack and new cargo racks that feature stronger tubing that is over 25% larger in diameter than the previous versions and have an additional tie-down loops located on them. Kawasaki has even included a factory-installed plastic conduit that's underneath the bodywork for easier winch installation. And of course, you can't miss those nice aluminum wheels that now come standard. Our findings? The good? There's no power as immediate nor as continuous as the big V-twin in the Brute Force. The transmission is simple in design, but is still one of the best. It engages early and without slip. And the engine braking through the transmission is incredibly natural feeling, never letting the ATV freewheel on those downhills. And the new power steering provides easy steering in every situation without ever feeling overpowered or free of feel. The bad? The front differential still whines and clicks every time it engages and disengages, and the brute force still sits a little tall and could sure use some better tires on those aluminum wheels. The bottom line? The brute force just keeps getting better. A complete package with an incredible engine, transmission, drive system, and now power steering. But our only complaint is with those silly stock tires. Add some radial tires and you're going to have an ATV that will continually amaze you with its power, handling, and its ability.